Sadly enough, many people don't know about all of those guys that were behind Bob Marley, that made Bob Marley famous. So-called unsung heroes, 1962, Trenchtown, Jamaica. I was there as one of the original Wailing Wailers. I coined the word reggae since I had it copyrighted in the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C., with him forward in the message of the prophecy. Reggae music speaks about truths and rights. Love, one heart, let's get together and you'll feel all right. One love, you know, everybody knows that. That's a Bob Marley song. It speaks about nonviolence, speaks about racism, speaks about bigotry. It addresses all the social ills. Sadly enough, many people have not been listening to the real lyrics of pure spiritual reggae music. Reggae music is very, very spiritual. And sadly enough, the music industry has tried to use music in order to divide people along racial lines. I am from the original school of reggae music, the pure and undiluted, spiritual, nonviolent reggae type music, which is what it's all about. Many people hear this fusion of reggae with hip-hop and dancehall, and seeing the videos with slack type of dancing and stuff like that. That is not true spiritual reggae music. Do not get it wrong. You know, it might have the beat of reggae music, surely, but that's not truly spiritual music. I personally want to address you know, our young people today in their audience, because sadly enough, I'm very sad. I came up through the ghettos of Trenchtown, Jamaica, which is worse than any ghettos that I've seen. Cabrini Green, East Lake Meadows, killings, drive-by shootings, every day and night. Every day, it's a constant thing. Bob Marley sings about No Woman, No Cry. Oh, I remember when we used to sit in a government yard in Trenchtown. No woman, no cry. Mothers mourning over the loss of their children. Shot down in the streets by drive-by shootings. Gang warfares. The same things are happening today all over the world. I'm very sad. So as most other legends of the music, we are losing our children. Our children are very angry because they have seen us adults set no proper example for them to follow. How many times, and I'm sure that in many homes, in the so-called ghettos, and this word ghetto has been used for so many different things around for so long, and yet I've never seen a sign saying you are entering the ghetto. So, you know, and Bob Marley sings about emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our mind. I've no fear for atomic energy, for none of them can stop the times. How long shall they kill our prophets, Martin Luther King, while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We got to fulfill the book. Won't you help me sing this song of freedom? For all I ever had is redemption song. Song of freedom. I want to leave peace and love with all of you people, and especially really to our children. How many times, I'm sure, in families, kids have seen their parents come home from work, the daily toil, and their mothers and their fathers crying and weeping, says, oh, I'm tired from the stress and strain of daily work. How many kids have to comfort their parents in homes? How many times these kids, instead of just trying to be kids and be happy, they have got so much strain on them, so much strain. That is the problem for their anger. That's one of the reasons for their anger. We have to come down from whichever pinnacle we're at. We have to come down. It doesn't matter, rich, poor, black, white, it doesn't matter. We have to come down and reason with our kids, or else this world will never be a better place. We have to nurture all these young minds. Believe me, when I see these children, Peter Church says, you can't blame the youths of today. You can't blame the youths. We got to teach the youths the right way. We got to teach them truth and justice. We are telling them about, hey, diddle diddle, jumping over the moon and all that stuff. Come on now, you know, and Christopher Columbus discovered this and that, you know. I mean, really, we have to teach them the right things. We got to teach them the truths and rights. We got to teach them love. And we got to set this by example. My purpose in life has always been to spread the music of truths and rights and peace and love through the message of the prophecy. And reggae music is a very, very spiritual music. Bob Marley did not get a chance to say that because he died very early. Peter Tosh didn't get a chance to say that because he was cut down by the same forces of the same system that he spoke out about. I am going to make sure, knowing the consequences fully well, that when you try to stand up for anything that's right and truthful in this society or societies of the world today, beware, there is always somebody out there that's going to try to cut you down. But if you are spiritually strong, and I've heard many of the speakers today spoke about spirituality, we must return to our spiritual roots, because as the book of Ephesians tells you, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but spiritual wickedness in high and low places. And that's why I'm saying that the music must be spiritual, and we must pass it on to each and every one of our children, so that the world might be a better place. Extol him that rideth upon the heavens by his name Jah, and rejoice before him, as found in Psalm 68 verse 4. And in the book of Jeremiah chapter 8, we also use a lot of biblical quotations in our music. If you listen to the lyrics of reggae music, you will hear a lot of Bible and spirituality in it. For the hurt of the daughter of my people am I hurt. I am black. Astonishment hath come over me, said the Lord God. Peace unto each and every one of you, my brethren, from Kingston, Jamaica. And hopefully we can, in some way, as Dr. Martin Luther King tried to do, bring peace to the world, so that his children, the world that he envisioned for his children, I'm sure that if he was alive, he would be crying today. Sometimes it brings tears to my eyes, believe me. But we cannot give up, because we know that one day each and every one of us will be free. Peace, my brothers and sisters.